those that are new to this, the way monologue night works. We have a group of actors up here on stage. They're in a wash of blues. One at a time, they're going to come down into the spotlight. They're going to do their monologue. When they are done with their monologue, please do not clap. What do we do, PPA students? We snap.
You're arresting us for curfew violation, is it? That means being the intelligent, well-trained law enforcement professional you are, you clearly know that our word curfew is derived from the French medieval term couvre-feu, which meant you had to put out the fire in your hearth. Fireplace, same meaning, different word, you know. Don't they have crossword puzzles in the donut shop?
I will not stay home and babysit my stupid sister. I'm going to a party, and so you can't make me do anything. Disruptive, I'll show you disruptive.
What's it doing? It looks like a car. What kind? Let me get a closer look. It looks sort of like a four-door. Wow, that's amazing, Dad. It is my car. Oh my God, it looks like it has a little scratch on the fender. Maybe both fenders. And the passenger side. Gee whiz, I'm sure glad I'm standing on the side of the road.
Let's see which one I'll be this time. A stoner, a surfer, a beamer, maybe a goth. Or maybe I should get my old-time religion, get with the Christians, shout hallelujah. It seems my dad takes me to a new town every 18 months. This is like my 32nd school, and I'm not even in 8th grade yet.
Why does she want to ruin my life? She's just supposed to blot me out like I have some sort of mistake. Like I'm a copy of a copy. Not as good as the original, not as good as you. You are so perfect. Everyone around me is so perfect. And there was nothing left over for me.
I'm not Miss Poison Beauty. I'm Mrs. Poison Beauty. I can't believe you just said that. I'm not a miss, I'm a missus. Just because you're married doesn't mean you can't be a beauty queen. Oh, this Vaseline. You just rub it on your teeth and prevents a sticky smile. Believe me, I never go anywhere without my crown, my Vaseline, and my duct tape.
And she'll be athletic. Someone I could hit fly balls to, and she'll catch every single one, and she'll love to read books and see plays, and we'll never run out of conversation. She's out there. Right now, the groom I'm going to marry is living in New York, Boston, or Philadelphia. Just walking around the streets, and I don't even know that I'm alive. It's crazy. Both of us were just waiting around to meet. Why can't you just call out to me, Eugene, here I am, come get me.
No one should ever need another person that badly. Do you believe that? No one should ever... What is that? Is that something you saw on TV? I dump my heart on the table, and you give me Dr. Joyce Brothers. Need, need. I'm saying I love you. Is that so wrong? Is that not allowed anymore?
The other night I dreamt that my father was inside of a baked potato.
Isn't that strange?
I was very startled to see him there, and then I began to worry that others would see where my father was and how small he was. So naturally, I just kept trying to close the baked potato, but I guess it was hot because he'd just start to cry whenever I'd shut it. You know, I thought about just sending the whole plate back to the kitchen and tell the cook, there's a person in my potato. But then the waiter came with the mocha cake and it had lava icing and, you know, I ate that.
My junior prom dress was powder blue and white. It had a white waistband and a white band around the bottom. Kind of like Cinderella, but with a big powder blue bow. But the problem was my date. He rang the bell, and I opened the door, and there he was. In a powder blue suit with the frilly white shirt and the powder blue bow tie. We matched. It was mortifying. And I had a really horrible time at the prom, too. Because afterwards, we went to a field and tipped cows.
You boiled it? You boiled my chicken? You boiled it like it was any old frozen hunk of flesh. You know, I raised that chicken from the incubator to the grave, and you boiled it with absolutely no consideration for the amount of labor involved.
I had to feed that chicken crushed corn every morning for a year. I changed its water. I had to kill it with an axe. I spilled its guts out. I had to pluck every feather on its body. And I did all of that work so you could take it and boil it?
What about me? What about me, huh? When my dad died, when you came to the funeral home that night, that stuff that you said to me, you're always doing that. The top 10 best things anyone has ever done for me have all been done by you. That's pretty good, right? I know. I'm so stupid. I'm just messed up. You know that. And so
sometime in this time, I want to wake up knowing that someone somewhere knows exactly what I'm feeling. Do you read much biology? Well, they figured it all out. How everyone says my blue is different from your blue. I mean, the sky. It's blue to me. Right now, almost cobalt, but to you, it could be what I call violet. Well, anyway, they've worked it all out that even if they put my brain into your body and hooked me out to your eyes, I'd still see my blue, because it's my brain that translates what the optic nerve sees.
Don't get me wrong, I admire her. She has one thing most of us lack. I know I do. One day, she asked a boy to take her to the dance, like it was the most natural thing in the world. I could never do something like that. I'd die. I'd absolutely die. And rejection? Huh, I think that's the worst word invented. I do. I truly do. I'd take bad skin any day.